Hi everyone, today we are discussing about applications and circuit analysis. Applications and circuit analysis. In electronics, we are using several parts like capacitor, inductor, resistor, variable resistor, diode, transmitter. These are all the several electronic elements which is more helpful to balancing the circuits. First one is resistor. A resistor is a circuit element that opposes the flow of electric current. For example, in any circuit, the circuit limit is, for example, 40 volts. The input supplying voltage is 100 volts. At that situation, we are using several resistors internally in different places. By using these resistors, it will oppose or it will avoid extra flow of current, and limited current will be propagates or passing through the circuit, and otherwise unwanted flow of current will be ignored or eliminated, or that will be opposed, and additional flow of current will be opposed. Only required current will be passing through the next stage. So that means in any circuit we are using several resistors. They are controlling extra flow of control. That is the main use of resistor. That's why a resistor is a circuit element. That process the flow of electric current. A resistor with resistance R is governed by that is more useful and more important in any electronic devices by using resistors. A resistor represents R, and R is governed by the relationship, and R is governed by the relationship V of T equal to Ri of T. V of T equal to Ri of T, where V and I respectively denoted the voltage across the current through the resistor as a function of time, where V and I respectively denote the voltage across the current through the resistor as a function of time. That means V of T means it is a flow of current. Ri of T is a resistance of current. It is directly proportional to the flow of current. In the frequency domain, the above relationship becomes V of W equal to Ri of W in the form of frequency domain, and that is time domain. Above equation, V of T equal to Ri of T is a time domain, where I of T equal to 1 by R V of T. Just I am simplifying or determining the I of T value, and the B side equation will be simplified. I of T equal to 1 by R V of T, and in the frequency domain, VW of or V omega of T equal to Ri of T. Here also I of omega equal to 1 by R V of omega, where V and I denotes the Fourier transform of V and I respectively. Fourier transform functions. In the circuit diagram of a resistor and symbol R or R, the symbol of resistor can be represented as like this. Here I of t is a flow of current, V of t is a voltage controller. By using resistor, sum of flow of current will be opposed, or it will sum of current will be opposed to control or balancing the circuit. How much of data will be opposed will be depends on the range of the resistor. In resistors, so many type of resistors, so many range of resistors is there. 1K, 2K, 3K, 1.5K, 100K, 11K, 15K, 3.3K, 270K. So these are the different ranges of resistors. By using the resistor, only one of the major concept is to balancing the flow of circuit. And the next one is inductor. An inductor is a circuit element. It is also one of the circuit element. An inductor is a circuit element. It is also used for to convert the electric current into magnetic field and vice versa. That means it is generally used in transistors, step up and step down transistors, and also used in several electronic equipments to balancing or connecting the flow or convert the flow of current from one form to another form. That means the overall concept of inductors an inductor is a circuit element that converts an electric current into a magnetic field. An inductor with inductance L, inductor is represents L, and the related equations of inductor in the time of with respect to time, V of t equal to L d I of t, L d by dt I of t, or equivalently I of t equal to 1 by L integration of infinity minus infinity to t V of tau d tau, where V and I are respectively denoted the voltage across the current through the inductor as the function of t, where V and I respectively denotes the voltage across the current, through the inductor as a function of time, That means in the frequency domain, the inductance will be represents V omega equal to J omega L I of omega, or equivalently I of omega equal to 1 by J omega L V of omega, where I and V denotes the Fourier transforms and of V and I respectively. And the related symbol of related circuit diagram or symbol of inductor is like this. I of t, V of t. Here clearly we are observing an inductor is a circuit element. That converts an electric current into magnetic field or magnetic current. That's why these type of inductors are used. And next we are seeing to the other topic. Next one is capacitors. In previous already we know what are the major components of electronic devices, capacitors, inductors, resistors, variable resistors, diode, ammeter, voltmeter, rheostat. So these are all the different types of equipments, transformers, transistors, diodes, inductors. And now third topic is capacitors, and it is also one of the circuit element, and it is also one of the circuit element that stores electric range. Resistor, the resistor working principle is it will oppose the flow of current, and the working principle of inductor is it will converts electric current to magnetic current. And third one is capacitors, and capacitors main working principle or object is a capacitor which will stores electric charge. Resistor oppose, but it will be store some electric charge, and it is also balancing the flow of current. For example, we require 12 volts power supply. The supplying voltage is 14 voltage. At the situation, extra 2 voltage will be stored by using capacitor. For example, 20 volts will be supplying on the circuit. That's a situation. Some of the capacitors store the extra energy, and also by using resistors, similarly, it will oppose the flow of current. So as that principles, we can easily operating the flow by using capacitor, resistor, inductor to balancing the circuit and execute the outputs from the output side. And the related equations of capacitor with respect to time, V of t equal to 1 by C, and integration infinity to t minus infinity to t t I of tau d tau, or equivalently I of t equal to c of d by dt v of t. And with respect to the frequency domain, v of w equal to j omega, v of w equal to 1 by j omega c I of j omega or w, or equivalently I of omega equal to j omega c of v omega. And the related circuit diagram of capacitor is like this. Here I of t is the flow of current, v of t is the storage current. I of t is the flow of current. Capacitor, it will store some flow of current and balance in the circuit. And that was the main working principle of capacitor and the symbols and the related equations. Next topic is the circuit analysis. Now we are entering to the main topic, circuit analysis. The Fourier transform is a very useful tool for circuit analysis. The Fourier transform is a very useful tool for circuit analysis. The utility of Fourier transform is partly due to the fact the differential or integral quantic equations that describe inductors and capacitors are much similar expressed in Fourier domain in the time domain. That means the overall concept of circuit analysis is it is Fourier transforms may also similar functions of inductor and capacitors may also similar functions of inductor and capacitor. And next one is one of the application, filtering. filtering. In many applications, we want to modify the spectrum of signal, either amplifying or attenuating certain frequency components. In many applications, we want to modify the spectrum of a signal by either amplifying or attenuating certain frequency components. This process of modifying the any circuit need some modifications to process the system. In this process of modifying the frequency spectrum of signal is called filtering. The process of modifying the frequency spectrum of a signal is called filtering. Filtering means frequency spectrum. Why we are using frequency spectrum? The main object of frequency spectrum, it will balancing or it will maintain or it will adjusting quality of the signals by using some adding frequencies with respect to the frequency spectrum. Frequency spectrum. And the other one is a system that performs filtering operation is called filter. Another meaning, a system that performs filtering operations is called filter. Filters are, many types of filters exist. They are, first one is frequency selective filter. Frequency selective filter pass. Frequency selective filter, first one is in frequency selective filter, pass some frequencies with little or no distortion while significantly attenuation other frequencies. Pass some frequencies with little or no distortion. For example, the overall meaning of frequency selective filter, it will oppose some extra frequency because to balancing the circuit. So last point, several basic types of frequency selective filters including low pass, high pass, band pass filters. Low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter. Why we are using low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter? For example, when I am receiving on circuit low frequency signal but I am need high frequency signals, so at that time input side it will receiving low frequency signals, and it will entering to the circuit and it will balancing the flow of circuit. For example, low frequency signals are received by the low pass, high pass, band pass filters, and then it will giving some extra frequency to the low frequency signals, or it will adding some extra frequency to the signals, or it will boosting the signals to increasing the size with respect to the time and amplitude. So by using these low pass, band pass, high pass filter, we can easily increasing or decreasing the size of the signals. So at the situations we are using these type of band pass, high pass, low pass. For example, if the inputs entering signal is high frequency signal, at the situation by using these filters we can also decreasing the size of the signals and wanted signal will be propagated through the output side. That means the overall concept of these three, LPF, low PF and BPF. LPF means low pass filter and IPF means high pass filter, BPF means band pass filter. By using three LPF, MPF and BPF, we can easily adjusting the frequency levels. Next one is ideal low pass filter. An ideal low pass filter eliminates all frequency components with a frequency whose magnitude is greater than some out cutoff, some cutoff frequency, while leaving remaining frequency components unaffected. An ideal low pass filter eliminates all. It will oppose the sum of extra frequency. So the overall concept of an ideal low pass filter eliminates all frequency components with frequency whose magnitude is greater than some cutoff frequency. That means, for example, in any circuit, for example, one circuit requires 20 megahertz frequency, but input side entering 30 megahertz. So extra 10 megahertz will be adding, but circuit requires only 20 megahertz frequency. At the situation, by using ideal low pass filter, we can easily oppose the extra flow of frequency. At the same time, it will avoid or it will ignore or it will oppose the extra frequency with respect to the various elements. And these type of filters are known as ideal low pass filters. Such a filter has a frequency response H of the form H of omega equal to 1 omega less than or equal to omega C, where C is the cutoff frequency, 0 otherwise. If 1 is presented, the wave will be propagates. If 0 is present, the wave is propagates from negative side. 1 is propagates, 1 is appearing, the wave is appearing on the right side only. If wave is 0, the wave is propagates to the negative side. Here we are observing there are three types: stop band, pass band. That means already in previous classes we know how we are know stop band and pass band. Stop band is nothing but in that particular time period there is no wave will be propagate. In that particular period there is no wave will be propagates. In pass band, in that particular period, the wave will be presented or propagates. That's why these are called pass band and stop band. Stop band means there is no signal propagates from the particular time period. By using pass band, it will executes or it will propagates some frequency on that particular wave. That's why these type of frequencies are known as ideal low pass filters, and these particular time periods are represents pass band and stop band, where H of W is the function of ideal low pass filter and WC is the cutoff wavelength. If 1 is present, wave propagates positive side. If 0 is present, wave propagates from negative side. That means another meaning, if one is activated, that is only called as if one is activated, the type of particular the type of particular time period is known as pass band. Why? Because one is represents the data propagation or active region. For example, 0 will be appearing, there is no data will be appearing on that particular time period. That's why we are indicating like this. And next one is reverse operation, ideal high pass filter. In previous we are explaining ideal low pass filter, and now we are explaining ideal high pass filter. Ideal high pass filter. An ideal high pass filter eliminates all frequency components. An ideal low pass filter eliminates all components with a frequency whose magnitude is less than some cutoff frequency. Magnitude from that low pass filter whose magnitude is greater than, in this high pass filter whose magnitude is less than. So these type of filters use for better communications of data signals, and it will reverse operation of low pass filters, ideal low pass filter. That's why the signal is propagates like this. Why? Because the function of condition will be changes. One represents one for mod omega greater than or equal to omega c, where c, omega c is the cutoff frequency, where omega c is the cutoff frequency. In this also we are observing a reverse operation. In this, one is present, it is like a stop band. In the above filter, one is present, it is a pass band. That means it will propagate flow of current on the circuit. But in the ideal high pass filter, one is present, that is a stop band condition. And at that particular period, there is no signal will be propagates. And other sides from left and right sides, the signal will, that's why it is called pass bands. Next one is ideal band pass filters. Now we are discussing the family of filters. And the first one is frequency selective filters and ideal low pass filter. Ideal high pass filter, ideal band pass filter. In ideal band pass filter, eliminates all frequency components with a frequency whose magnitude does not lie in particular range, while leaving the remaining frequency component unaffected. That means it will maintain some particular constant to frequency. If any cases some electronic are affected at the situation, it will oppose the frequency components. Why? Because frequency components are unaffected. So some frequency components are damaged. So these problems are overcome to we are using ideal band pass filters, and the function of ideal from band pass filter h of omega w equal to 1 omega c less than equal to mod omega less than equal to omega c to 0 otherwise. In this we are seeing the data propagation in 4 signs WC1, WC2, minus WC1 and minus WC2. Already we know why we are using pass band and stop bands. Pass band is nothing but there is no wave or data will propagate from that particular period, and pass band is used for to propagate flow of current on the circuit on particular time period. Next one is amplitude modulation, one of the most important topics. Capacitor, resistor, inductor, ideal high pass filter, ideal low pass filter, ideal band pass filter. And why we are using capacitor, inductor and resistor? Already we know by using resistor it will oppose the flow of current when the current is will be added extra no load at the situation, it will oppose the flow of current as a particular range. And why we are using capacitor? In any circuit some extra power will be entering to the circuit at the situation. By using capacitor to store some of electrical source and balance in the flow of circuit, and we are using several capacitors to store the a little bit of flow of current and balance in the circuit. So at that purpose we are using capacitor. And why we are using inductors? Inductors are mainly used for to convert the electrical current into magnetic current. And what are the advantages of high pass, low pass, band pass filters? By using high pass, low pass, band pass filters, we can easily adjusting or balancing the flow of current, flow of circuits. Next one is motivation of amplitude modulation. AM, amplitude modulation. By using amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the carrier will changes with respect to the instantaneous time of the signals. And next one is motivation for amplitude modulation. In communication systems, we often need to transmit signal using frequency ranges. That range is different from that of original signal. For example, voice or audio signals typically have information in the range of 0 to 20 kilohertz. Often it is not practical to transmit such a signal using its original frequency range. Two potential problems with such an approaches are interference and constraints of antenna length. Since the signals are broadcast over the airways, we need to ensure that no two transmitters use the same frequency bands in order to avoid interference. That means the overall concept of amplitude modulation, it will balancing the flow of circuit and maintain constant voltage levels, and it does not use same value of same value of frequency bands. Why? Because it will affected by receiving process. So that's why we are avoid interference of free of flow of current or flow of frequency on the particular circuits. Next one is tribal amplitude modulation system. These are the several equations: transmitter side and receiver side. X of t is the input and y of t is the output. In receiver side, y of t is the input and x of t is the x cap of t. Just we are observing why it is indicating x cap of t. Why it is indicating x cap of t? X of t is a message signal and x cap of t is a demodulated signal, that means original signal. So that's why we are just representing, one is modulating signal and the other one is demodulated signal. Both are same signals, but the using elements are change. Here we are seeing the transmitter characterized, receiver characterized, and clearly we are mentioning several equations. V of t equal to E of j omega t x of t, where y of omega equal to x of omega minus omega c. Omega c is a cutoff wavelength. Receiver side, x cap of t equal to e power j omega t y of t. It is equals to x cap of omega y of omega plus w t. So the overall of x cap of t, the modulated signal, x of t equal to e of j omega c t e power minus j omega c t x of t. And we are simplifying or we are cancelling e of j omega t and e of minus j omega t. So both are cancelling. The final equation is x of t equal to x cap of t equal to x of t. Already circuit diagram represents clearly x is a input signal and x cap is also original message signal. So that means x is also same as x cap of t. X and x, x cap is represents original input signals. That's why the equation represents like this. And next one is amplitude modulation system, tribal amplitude modulation system examples. So in this type of waveforms represents tribal amplitude modulation systems, tribal amplitude modulation systems, and we are observing several examples of transmitter input to receiver output. First, transmitter input is splitted or quantized. Transmitter input splitted or quantized several quantized several conversions, like sine wave is converted into sampling and quantized signals, and then after again it will be converted into sine wave. So by using these techniques already we know. In previous classes we know how it will be works. In previous classes we know clearly how it will be works. A continuous CT, continuous time signals, will be converted into discrete time signals. And by using sampling and quantizer and encoding and decoding. Sampling, quantizer, encoding and decoding. We can convert the continuous sine signals into discrete time signals, and the discrete time signals is into converted into digital signals. So in that we are using major three elements. First one is sampler, second one is quantizer, third one is encoder. By using sampling, it will converts CT to DT. It will converts CT to DT. A continuous time signal is converted into discrete time signal. Discrete means it will assigning some equal intervals, or it will changing the sine wave into equal intervals of pulses. So then after DT is again converted into DS. First one is CT, second one is DT, third one is DS, digital signal. So in this conversions we are mainly classified two types. First one is sine wave is converted into sampling wave. Sampling wave is converted into quantized waves, and quantized waves are converted into digital signals. Simply C to D, D to DS, digital signals. That's why when I am in applying input side sine wave, that means voice signal, and output side also I am receiving voice signal. In that process, best example is telecommunications. In telecommunications, human beings are provides a subscriber or caller use voice data is a sine wave. It will be converted is in the form of some digital signals, and then after it will information into analog. That means in any electronic device internally using electric microphones and earphones, in any mobile both are used. Why? Because one is microphone is used for to convert the analog to digital signals, earphones are convert the digital to analog. So by using these two signals we can easily convert the signals from one form to another form, from one form to another form. And these are the several applications and several major electronic components: resistor, capacitor, inductor, high pass filter, low pass filter, band pass filter, and ideal low pass filter, ideal high pass filter, ideal high pass filter, ideal low pass filter, ideal band pass filter. And the another examples of modulation. Modulation means modifying, modulating, that means converting the signals from one form to another form. So these are the different applications and examples of different major electronic components. And next class we are discussing more topics. Thank you.